StreamerBot explained triggers. The release of StreamerBot 0.2.0 included a large overhaul to the event system with the introduction of triggers. You now have more control over events and their execution through trigger configuration options, and events can now trigger more than one action. Triggers, as the name suggests, trigger actions. Along with the actions and sub-actions, this is the core logic of how StreamerBot works. At the time of recording, there are over 330 different triggers in StreamerBot. And as we grow and evolve, this number is increasing. So it's important to know how triggers work and the different types. Triggers are easily added by going into the Actions tab, right-clicking in the Triggers window, and this will allow you to select your trigger. In StreamerBot, there are several types of triggers. Firstly, we have basic triggers. These triggers require no additional configuration. An example of this would be the StreamerBot starter trigger. Toggle triggers. These triggers involve checkbox configuration, allowing you to turn settings on and off with ease. Ticking all the boxes will cause this to be in any trigger. One example of this would be the Twitch subscription. Select triggers. These triggers involve drop downs, so you can select the option you want, and they will also include any option. One example here would be the command triggered. Range triggers. These triggers involve using numbers to control when the trigger executes. Just entering a min value will trigger equal or above the amount. Just entering a max will trigger on exactly this amount. Entering both will create a range inclusively, meaning if you put 100 and 200 in the min and max, then anything in between and including 100 and 200 will cause the trigger to execute. Leaving this blank will cause it to be in any trigger. Perfect example here is Twitch shears. The final type is text. These triggers have a text box for you to enter a value in if you wish to help specify the configuration. Leaving it blank will cause it to be in any trigger. The first words trigger would be an example of this. It's also worth noting that triggers could include one or more of these types. Triggers also introduce the ability to easily test your actions. Each trigger has a context menu where you will find a test trigger option. Just give it a click to test, which will allow you to test that specific trigger on that action. You can also take this step further with simulate events, but we'll cover that in another video. Inside the context menu, you can also enable and disable triggers. You can also remove triggers, and you have the ability to copy and paste. The final bit of information you will need to know about triggers is how the don't run if works. This setting allows you to stop a trigger from running if another trigger of the same type runs. Within the UI, when you right click on a trigger, there will be a menu item, Don't Run If, and within this menu will be listed the action and criteria of the trigger of any of the same trigger types. If a trigger has been marked as Don't Run If in another trigger, then it will not show up in the target trigger. This is a sanity check, otherwise a stalemate will happen and neither would run. An example of this is as follows. You have three actions, cheer 1, cheer 2, and cheer 3. Each of these actions has a Twitch cheer trigger set to 1 to 100, 1 to 100, and exactly 50 respectively. The 1 to 100 trigger in cheer 2 has the cheer 3 exact 50 checked in the don't run if menu. This means that if you get a cheer of 50 bits, then cheer 1 and cheer 3 will trigger. Cheer 2 will not trigger because you have told it not to through the don't run if setting, even though the cheer amount is within the range. Thank you for watching. If you have any other questions or need any more assistance, please feel free to reach out in Discord. Link for that is in the description. Also, you can check out some of these other videos to teach you more about Streamer.bot.